Hey everybody, hunter, fisher, trapper, trader, guide, scout, and interpreter, and country cook Steve Hall here in Nashville, Tennessee, along with pretty Miss Sheila behind the camera helping us out today. Got a quick tip. In an earlier recipe, I used some condensed milk. And here's the scenario. You get right in the middle of a recipe and it calls for condensed milk. Don't jump in your $20,000 car and drive $6 worth of gas down through the traffic to go in and get one stupid little can of condensed milk. Now, a lot of people use it in ice cream and some other recipes. Well, I'm going to show you how to make it. First of all, you can just use like 2% milk. 2.5 cups we're going to pour in here. And this is one of those low and slow things. Kind of like making a roux, only we're going to make sweetened condensed milk today. 2.5 cups of milk, 1 cup of sugar. We're going to put it in there right away because we want to start stirring this before the heat even starts building in the pan. So in other words, put it in there and kind of start stirring it, then turn your burner on because you want to get this sugar as dissolved as you can possibly get it. And then later on in the recipe, we're going to take just a little pinch of baking soda and put in there. It kind of helps foam it up for a little bit. Then it goes back down to condensed milk. Why some people use it, I couldn't even tell you. And you don't even need it. If you just want to make condensed milk with milk and sugar, you can do that. But today we do happen to have some baking soda out of the refrigerator in that little box. We're just going to put a pinch in it right at the very end, just before we finish up. So 2.5 cups of milk, 1 cup of sugar, stir it slow. And let's get the camera up here and we'll take a look at what we're doing. We're still rocking and rolling here, and you notice the steam really coming out of here. And what I did to make sure that this sugar dissolved really good is, like I said, I put it right in when the milk was cold and started stirring it immediately. Then I turned the burner on and I slowly been heating it up. And buddy, I can't feel nothing in there. All the sugar is dissolved. That's a real good way to make sure it gets done. Because it takes a lot longer to heat something up when you're stirring it, because it wants to cool it down, obviously. And we're going to bring this up to a simmer. And they use this in a lot of homemade ice cream recipes, condensed milk, because you don't use regular sugar, you use liquid sugar. Sheila was saying down there that they, every time they even get a little dab of snow down in Alabama, they make snow cream, is it? Is that what it's called? So if you're up in Minnesota, you get plenty of snow, which Sheila don't want to see any more of that. We were up last winter in Minnesota, and I told her if a snowstorm comes up, man, get in behind a snowplow. That's the safest place to be. Of course, her and her girlfriends, you know, Dolores and Lori and Cheryl, they're all going to go out shopping. They go down to the Mall of America. They got in a snowstorm, and they did exactly what I said. They got in behind a snowplow to be safe. Follow the snowplow. After about an hour, the guy pulled over and says, "Lady, what are you doing?" She said, "Well, Steve Hall, Shotgun Red, he's from up here in Brainerd, Minnesota, and we were going down and do a little shopping." And he said, "If I get in a snowstorm like we're in right now, to get in behind the snowplow, it's the safest place." He said, "Lady, you can keep following me if you want. I'm almost done with the Walmart parking lot, and then I'm going to go over and do Target." So anyway, I'm not sure all of that's true, but it's just about up to a simmer, and we're going to let it simmer for another 20 or 30 minutes. Once it hits that simmer before it starts boiling, I'm going to turn the heat down, and we'll see you in a little bit. Here is kind of an update. We've been simmering this, and it builds a little bit of film. What it's doing, it's cooking out the impurities in the milk and the sugar. So we are going to take a spoon and take that little bit of foam off the edge of that and take it out of there. So we get a better product. We are about 25 to 30 minutes into simmering this here. There we go. And the rest can probably stir back in. We just wanted to get that thickest amount there. And I wanted to show it to you that it did build just a little bit of film around the outside as it was simmering. But here's the thing, we don't hardly have much product left in here. It's really starting to get down to only like a cup or so. And we start out, remember, with 2.5 cups of milk and 1 cup of sugar. So we're only gonna give this about another 10 minutes and then we're gonna turn the burner off, add a little pinch of that baking soda and let it foam and do its thing. And maybe that baking soda helps bring some more of that foam out. We'll find out in just a second. Now, believe it or not, there's probably lots and lots of people out there that have made their own condensed milk. But there's also lots and lots of people like me that until you cook with a recipe that requires condensed milk, you didn't even really pay any attention to it in the store. And in addition to that, you didn't know you could make your own. So that's what these recipes are for, is folks that just go, hey, you know what? I'm glad you put that on there. I'm glad you posted it. Because now I know how to make my own sweetened condensed milk for homemade ice cream and all that stuff that requires you to use that. What I did is I made some lemon pie the other day. Me and Sheila did lemonade pie. It had condensed milk in it, and of course it's room temperature condensed milk that we're going to cool this down to, and some whipped cream or Cool Whip, and a can of lemonade, frozen lemonade, and you blend it all together and pour it in a graham cracker crust. And it was Sheila's over there rolling her eyes right now, because it was like we had to give it to the neighbor after we had a slice apiece, because it's just dangerously good. And but a gentleman said, hey, I love the recipe, I can't wait for the condensed milk thing. And you know who you are now, because you sent it in. So I'm doing this recipe for you there, buddy. I wish I knew his name. I guess I could have went and looked on the— it was something. I can't think of it off the top of my head, but we're going to go ahead and let this cook for just about another 5 or 10 minutes. And remember now, because you can make it as thick as you want, but as it cools, it gets a lot thicker. So we'll give this a try. In fact, I'm going to turn the burner down on this a little bit. I'm going to give it a couple stirs, and then I'm going to put in a pinch right now of baking soda. Just a pinch. Boy, look at it foam up white. Don't let that scare you, because it's going to go back to a yellow tint in a little bit. Look at how that got just all foamy from that baking soda. I'm going to turn the burner off completely, all the way down. Look at that. It doubled in size in liquid. And we're going to let this cool down a little bit. Keep stirring it. Don't let it burn at all. But look at that, how it foamed it right up. And that was just a pinch of that baking soda. That's all it was. Now it's starting to settle down a little bit. Isn't that amazing? Can you see that in the camera, Sheila?
Yeah, it's really creamy.
It's got real creamy and real puffy-like. Like it just got real light. So, and maybe that helps it transform to do something, so. But we'll go ahead and let this cool down, and we're going to turn the camera off. We'll be back just in about 5 minutes. We'll see you in just a second. I moved the pot from this burner over to this burner, which hasn't been used at all, so it's just room temperature. This is still putting out enough heat to where it wanted to keep it simmering, and I wanted to stop the cooking process to see how— see, look at that. Underneath that foam that it generated, it's got a nice golden look to it. So we're going to let this cool off completely. And it was, I guess it was about a total of 40 to 45 minutes of cooking time. We were looking at the clock here. And we'll show you the finished product when it cools clear down to room temperature. Because that'll take a little bit, probably about 30 minutes. And then we'll pour it into a cup and we'll take a look and see what we have. See you in just a second. Tell you what I did. I moved it back after I stirred that foam down a little bit. I moved it back on the burner and brought it back to a simmer one more time. And there's a point like right now that you can feel it starting to get thick on your spoon, to where it changes consistency. The whole time it's been a little bit thin, and now just all of a sudden it is getting almost like a watered down pudding. You can just feel that it has a little bit of pressure on your spoon when you stir it back and forth. It's just wonderful texture. Now we're going to cool it the rest of the way down, and we'll show you what it looks like when it's nice and cool. See you in a minute. You know me, I cheated. And here's a tip you can do. I had Sheila go in and pour some cold water in the kitchen sink about 2 inches deep, and throw in a couple handfuls of ice cubes out of the refrigerator, or actually the freezer, and then we went in and sat this down in it and stirred it to make it cool quickly instead of waiting for a long time so we could come back to the camera. And by the way, the guy I went in and looked, the guy that wanted us to make this recipe, his channel is King King O' Games. King, like a king, O just like the letter, and then Games, G-A-M-E-S. King O' Games, here you go. Here's your product. It's all done. Now, we got to show you the magic thing here. Are you ready for this, Sheila?
I'm ready.
She's doing the stirring here. Now watch this. Just kind of hold that straight up like that. And this is for you folks. I'm going to have you step back, make sure I got this on frame. Because I want this to be in the frame. Show me, tell me when that little cup's in the frame there.
It's in the frame.
Go this way just a little.
Right.
Right there.
Right.
You like that? Are you ready for this? Look at this nice, thick, condensed milk. And look how much we got. Just maybe a cup. I was pouring it that way so you could see it. Well, I'm going to turn around here and go ahead and get the rest out of here. I know this is probably blocking the camera shot. And I'll tell you something else, too. If you get a drop of this on your finger, you'll probably pour this over your breakfast cereal because this stuff is absolutely wow. Isn't that delicious, Sheila? Let's see here. Right at a cup, and isn't that something? We started out with 2.5 cups of milk and added a cup of sugar to it, which takes up volume, and cooked it for, let's give it 45 minutes. You don't have to let it cool down and then restart it like I did. How am I looking this way? Pretty good. All right. And you don't have to let it cool down. Just keep it at a simmer. Stir it. Just take a pinch of that. And I mean just enough to get a pinch between your fingers. That's all you need for baking soda. And that's right towards the end of the process. Stir it again until it's cooled down. Let it cool completely down. And I'll tell you what. Look how nice and thick that product is. Here I am with the official stirrer of the condensed milk, Pretty Miss Sheila. Isn't that stuff wonderful?
Awesome.
What could you use that for?
On cinnamon rolls.
That is a great idea. Cinnamon rolls or pancakes, maybe a little drizzle over pancakes or homemade ice cream or any other recipe that asks for sweetened condensed milk. Don't go to the store and buy it. It's very expensive. It comes in a little dinky can about 2.5 inches high and about big rounds of 50 cent piece. I think it's about $4. Here you can just make it if you got a little time. Low and slow, 45 minutes I would say minimum, and you'll end up with this product right here.
It's really good.
It is really good. Do you know where the subscribe button is?
Right here.
Right across there, that's right. If you click on that, then you'll be the first to know when we come out with another recipe. And if you got any recipe ideas, you can always send them to shotgunredcompany@yahoo.com and maybe we'll do them on the show. Thanks again for all your suggestions and for watching our videos. And is this the best homemade condensed milk you'll ever taste on a little spoon? If it ain't, it ought to be. We'll see you next time right here on Cooking with Shotgun Red. Check out all our recipes. Bye-bye.